COVID restrictions are having a devastating impact on many businesses, but Lake of Bays Brewing is one of the businesses that's feeling the impact quite heavily. Owner Darren Smith says usually they'd be running tours through the Baysville Brewing facility this time of year with tastings as well, but obviously that can't happen this year.
At this time of year, lots of tastings. We get groups of people coming in who are up for the holidays. They want to do a tour, try some of the beer, fill up a growler, take it away with them. So we're still able to do take-home beer sales, but we're obviously not doing tours back into the brewery right now. Not really encouraging people to stop for tastings as much as we'd love to. So it's more just come in, let us know what you'd like. We'll pack it up for you and then send you on your way.
But Smith says the bigger impact is to the two restaurants Lake of Bays runs, the Brew House in Huntsville and the newly opened Barrel House in Bracebridge.
Really does tamp down the amount of business that we can do in a day. It's unfortunately resulted in a fair number of layoffs as well right before Christmas, which was which has been tough for us and for the staff. But on the good side, we have been getting really great support from the community in terms of takeout business for food and for beer. Mm-hmm. People coming in and grabbing both, which has been really nice to see. And we've even seen a lot of people coming in and buying gift cards, looking to support businesses that way, where maybe they're not doing their office Christmas party this year, so they're sending their staff home with a gift card to go and support a local business. And people have been coming in and buying a lot of them, actually, which has been really, really nice to see.
The Barrel House has presented the biggest challenge as its opening was already delayed earlier this year due to COVID.
It was an interesting year for sure. I mean, the biggest challenge was obviously at first the construction shutdown, which went on for close to 2 months. So we were about halfway completed when that came down. We were aiming to be open in the spring. It resulted in us only being able to open in August, so we missed most of the summer. Mm-hmm. And then obviously when we got open, we were only able to operate at first at half capacity, and then now that's been steadily pared down to only 10 people in the restaurant. So funnily enough, before we moved to Red, we were actually really pleased with the numbers that we were seeing in Bracebridge, and really, really pleased with the support that the restaurant had been getting. I think long term, we've got a winner there. People seem to be liking it. It's just a matter of kind of making it through the next few months.